Hello everyone, welcome to UPSC Pathshala. Today is 16th of July 2020 and we'll be discussing today's current affairs in depth. Now let's see what is the first news. So the first news is about a study on the world population trends. So recently, a study was conducted by researchers at University of Washington's Institute for Health Metrics and Evaluation. So they have studied the world population trends in 195 countries. And for studying this population trend, they have used data from Global Burden of Disease Study 2017 to model future population in various scenarios as a function of fertility, migration, and mortality rates. So they have used data from the Global Burden of Disease Study 2017. And the population trend in 195 countries has been analyzed. Now, this particular news will be useful for your GS paper 1 under the heading Population and Associated Study Issues, Poverty and Developmental Issues, Urbanization, Their Problems and Their Remedies. Now, what are the key findings of the report? We'll be dealing with them one by one. So, firstly, the report says that the world population will peak in 2064. At 9.73 billion. So in 2064, the world population will be at 9.73 billion. Now, this is 36 years earlier than the 11 billion peak projected for 2100 by last year's UN World Population Prospect. So the UN World Population Prospect had predicted that by 2100, the world population will be at 11 billion. But now, according to this study, it says that the world population will reach 9.73 billion by 2064. And this is now 36 earlier than the UN report. Now, for 2100, the report projects a decline to 8.79 billion from the 2064 peak. So the report says that after 2064, there would be a decline in population and by 2100, it would reach to 8.79 billion. Unlike the UN World Population Prospect report, which says that by 2100, the world population will be at 11 billion. Now, it talks about total fertility rate. So the global total fertility rate is predicted to steadily decline from 2.37 in 2017 to 1.66 in 2100. So the fertility rate will also decline at the global level to 1.66. Now it is projected to fall below 2.1 in 183 countries. And in 23 countries, including Japan, Thailand, Italy, and Spain, it is projected to shrink by more than 50%. So in certain countries, it will move below 2.1. So those are around 23 countries and it includes Japan, Thailand, Italy and Spain. Now for a generation to exactly replace itself, the replacement level total fertility rate is taken to be 2.1. So when an entire generation will replace itself, that replacement will be at 2.1. So this is predicted by the report. Now there are certain India related findings too. So the report says that India by 2100, India will reach a population of 1.09 billion. So it will have the highest population in the world. Followed after India would be Nigeria, then China, and after that USA. So India would be the highest population country in the world. So the report projects a peak of 1.6 billion in 2048, up from 1.38 billion in 2017. So India's population would reach at 1.6 billion by 2048. And by 2100, there would be a decline, as has been predicted for other countries. So decline would be by 32% and the population will reach to 1.09 billion. Now, India's total fertility rate is already below 2.1 in 2019, and it will reach 1.29 in 2100. So the fertility rate would further decline. It has to decline because, according to the report, India has to reach a population of 1.09 billion by 2100. The number of working age adults, that is from 20 to 64 in India, it is projected to fall from around 748 million in 2017 to around 578 million in 2100. So the working age population, so people who are eligible for work, even that will decline to 578 million. Now, however, this will be the largest working age population in the world by 2100. Though in India, the working age population will decline, but still it will be the largest working age population in the world. Now, in the mid-2020s, India is expected to surpass China's workforce population. So it will surpass China's workforce population. So this is the case. Then from 2017 to 2100, India is projected to rise up the list of countries with the largest GDP from 7th to 3rd. Then India is projected to have the second largest net immigration in 2100, with an estimated 500,000 more people immigrating to India in 2100 than emigrating out. So the people who will be coming to India, those will be more than those moving out of India in 2100. And among the 10 countries with the largest population in 2017 or 2100, India is projected to have one of the lowest life expectancies. It will reach to 79.3 years in 2100, up from, it will be 79.3 years in 2100, up from 69.1 in 2017. In 2100, what will happen? India will have the lowest life expectancy. Now, all these findings, they obviously come with challenges. So what are the challenges ahead? So the forecast highlight huge challenges to economic growth as the workforce will shrink. We know it will shrink in India and obviously it will shrink worldwide. So there will be burden on health, social support systems. All this would be managed because of the aging population. Now, it also forecasts continued trends in female education attainment and access to contraception, and this will hasten decline in fertility and slow population growth. So as with time, females will get more educated and their access to contraceptions will also increase. Thus, the fertility rate would decline, and leading to it, the population growth will also slow down. So what needs to be done, or what is the way ahead? So countries should address the potential catastrophic impact of the shrinking work age population. So the shrinking work age population problem should be addressed. Certain measures have been suggested, like incentives to increase total fertility rate using artificial intelligence as a path towards self-sufficiency. Then wealthy countries such as the UK and US could counteract the impact of these changes through net migration of working age adults from the countries with growing population. So people, wealthy countries, what they can do, they can take people from who are poorer countries, or you can say underdeveloped countries, from them. And this, what they can do, they can negate this impact. Then the effect of fertility decline on women's reproductive health rights has to be accompanied by greater economic independence. So the decline on women's reproductive health rights, it should be accompanied by greater economic independence. So the women should become economically independent. Now, this would allow women to negotiate with the system on their own terms and for better support services as well. So this was about the study on world population trends.
Thank you for watching this video. If you enjoyed watching this video, then don't forget to like, comment and share the video. Subscribe to UPSC Pathshala and hit the bell icon to get the latest updates. Don't forget to register for our free live classes. Find the link in the description box. This is your chance to prepare yourself with personal trainers.